Hi everyone, it's Tammy and I am here to do the September jolly mail. I hope that this angle is okay. I know it's not the best and maybe I need to work kind of up here in this area. I am in Dallas. I am here on a business trip. And obviously you have extra time sometimes when you are on a business trip. And that is what it's like today. Today is Monday. I'm not sure when all of these will be posted, but I did a video yesterday to kind of tell you what I was doing. And I did a little bit of the stuff from the paper pumpkin. But oh, this is my jewelry. I need to get that out of the way. I brought some stuff from home, and then I also brought two paper pumpkin packages and my whole Stampin' Up! Package from the Jolly Fat Elf. So I know I will need my stamp block, and I have some black stamp ink. I do not have any markers with me, which I kind of thought maybe I should buy some, but I did not when I went to Target the other day. So I don't think I'm going to do any coloring. I'll just have to do the stamping, and then I'll do the coloring later. So it looks like the first one is called Dracula's Window, and it's really pretty cute. I need to stamp the Dracula image. Oh, these are the rubberized stamps. These are not, which I like because they stamp really well, but I kind of like the photopolymer a little better. Gosh, I don't even remember how to do these. I need to look at the instructions. This might be a whole video on itself. Oh, and I don't have my glasses on. Let's see, I think I have some in my purse. Yes, I do. Okay. To assemble the clear mount stamps, remove the stamped image from the rubber sheet. Remove the backing and adhere the label to the stamp. Remove the top liner from... Oh, hold on. I guess I didn't read it all. Remove the image from the stamp. So here we go. Remove the backing from the foam. You can now see the stamp as, you can now use the stamp as is, or you could clear here the clear image to it. I'm not going to do that. I will just, I don't know. I know that you can put like here's the little Dracula image. You can put this on here, but for some reason I think that that doesn't make it stay as well. I don't know. At least that's what I've heard. So I'm just going to stamp it here. We'll just do it this way. We're going to kind of go a quick and easy route. Again, this is from the Jolly Fat Elf, and she does these monthly subscription boxes, and you don't know what you're getting, but they are always awesome, and I would highly recommend it. She does a month at a time, or you can do a subscription where you do 3, 6, or 12 months maybe, I don't remember exactly. I did the 12 month because you got him the lowest price doing it that way. And to me, that's how I rationalize things in my head. So yeah, I'm kind of weird that way, I think, but I don't care because I like it. So I think the first step is to adhere this to here. Sometimes I don't really read all of her instructions. I just look at the picture and go with what I think I want to do. I did bring some inks, so I might be able to do some inking or whatever, but yeah, this is just a regular card and we're just going with it. I think I will need to stamp the Dracula onto this, and I'm going to use some black, and I know that I brought a little black ink spot. And with these being so little, it's easier almost to take the ink spot to the stamp. So that's kind of what I'm doing. Not kind of. This is what I'm doing. And then I will stamp directly onto the white. And just kind of push down all the way. And then hold the white with my nail and pull straight up. And I have a cute, crisp, clear image of Dracula. Okay, so stamp the Dracula image. Oh, and then she says to color it, but I'm not going to be able to color it. And then there's... Oh, and he's kind of hanging upside down from the window. That's kind of cute. Yeah, I'm not going to be able to do all of this. I was kind of hoping I'd be able to do a little more, but that's okay. So I'm not going to be able to color him exactly, I don't think. I do have a blender pen that I got with her stuff, and I have some colors here. Maybe I can do this after all if I... if I am careful. I don't know if I have all the colors that she used, but that's okay. I have some colors, so let's just pull out what I have. So this is called Making It Work. She colored his face green, and I don't know, I'm just not gonna do that, I don't think. I think I'm just gonna make his face kind of a neutral color, maybe. Let's see how this works. I've never used a blender pen with these kind of stamp pads. I'm just gonna go for it. And this lighting here, it has a lot to be desired. And when I say a lot to be desired, I mean like more than a little. It's horrible. I wonder if I would be better. I think you guys can see. Oh no, you guys can't even see this, sorry. You can just kind of tell what I'm doing. It's kind of giving him a little bit of a, oops, of a gray kind of a face. Which isn't horrible, it's... my blender pen isn't very juicy, and I don't know, this is... I've never used the Stampin' Up! Blender pen, so I'm not sure if it's supposed to be. So I'm just kind of going with it. I wonder if the other end is. Let's see. No, they're both very dry. I might have to ask her if that's the way they're supposed to be, or if I should like try to re-wet it somehow. And if I am supposed to re-wet it, I wonder what I would use. Because these aren't alcohol-based. I wonder if I would just use water. I'm almost inclined to get it wet with water anyway. I have my tea here, and you know what? I'm gonna... okay, don't do that, guys. I just thought that that might give it a neat tea color. So this is kind of green. It's kind of weird looking. It kind of... I mean, it works. It's a vampire, so it's fine. And then I'm gonna give him dark hair, because all vampires that I know have dark hair. And I don't even have a black marker, so I think what I will do is use the other end of this. I don't know what I did with my lid. I'm just going to leave them off because they're dry anyway. I use the other end and do black. But first, let me see. What color do I want to make his cape? Let's do that first. So the black will be last. I will do his eyes in this cucumber crush color. I don't remember what color Edward's eyes are. I know that his eyes were very appealing, but I don't remember what color they were. And then maybe I could do like a yellow around the sides of the eyes. I don't know if I have a yellow. I don't really. I have a cream color. Let's see how that looks mixed with this green color. Huh, it does kind of look yellow. Not too shabby. And maybe I'll take a little bit of the red. I have some Cajun craze over here in a stamp spot. Oh, I haven't opened it yet. This came in with this month's paper pumpkin. I always forget the name of it. I have to think about it. This is hard to open. That should do the trick. Yes. Yes, indeedy. So now let's just go in with a little bit of red, because I don't know. Now it just kind of looks dark, but oh well, I'm going with it. It's good. I'm calling that good. And then I wish I had some purple for his, oh, I kind of have a purple for his little cape. It looks like you're not going to see it all on the card. Well, see, that works kind of well. Oh, that might have been the Cajun craze that was doing that, because I don't know if you guys can see this. Oh, I'm not doing a very good job of making sure this is in the field of view. Because it looks like only a little bit of this is going to show. Oops, I just dropped the case. Oh. I'm going to do a little bit of Cajun craze too. I'll show you what it's looking like so far. And I forgot his little hand. It needs to be that greeny color too. So let me go back to that. There we go. Oops. This is actually working out a little nicer than I expected it to, so I can't complain too much. I'll use this and go over a little bit more of, yeah, this Cajun craze, whatever color, it colors a lot nicer than the other ones. So maybe the black will do all right too. So here's what we have so far. And I'm going to cut off some of his body, at least it looks like, with the, with something. So with this, because he's going to be peeking through the window. So I think I'm going to call that good. And then I'm going to do some of his hair here. And that actually seems to be working out pretty well as well. So I know that you guys can't see this as well as I'd like, but we are making do and scrapbooking or card making in a hotel room. I think that this is at least pretty cool for that effort. Because honestly, it looks pretty good. And I just brought a few supplies. I did not bring markers. Thank goodness she sent me the blender pen, because that does work. So that's pretty cute, isn't it? I'm calling him colored. And then, let's see, she has some blended ink around the outside of him. I'm going to, let's see what I can do with this. Kind of to make it look like the moon is shining behind him, kind of. And this isn't as good as the rest of it, maybe, but this color isn't exactly a yellowy color. It's kind of a mustard, taupey kind of yellow. But again, I don't think it's horrible. And I think if I were to get this as a Halloween card, I would be like, oh, that's cool. And I would know what it meant or what it was supposed to be. So I'm kind of okay with that. Shows up a little bit more green here in the picture than, or on the video, than it does on my, in real life. So, and then there's a gray wall, and I'm going to use this taupe to kind of gray it up a little bit. Kind of make it look a little more vintage and old. There, that's pretty cool. kind of started out looking something like that, and now it looks like that. I guess I should cover up my black ink too. And I'm going to take a drink of my tea. Okay, so then adhere the Dracula to the back of the window. Oh, so you adhere him to here. And I'm going to adhere him. I don't know how to adhere him. I kind of colored him right in the middle, which isn't a bad thing, just that I don't want to cover up his whole face. And if I did it this way, you'd see stuff in the background, so I have to be careful. I'm trying to figure out how to place him. And this is like the best way to place him, and it comes right in the middle of his face, which I don't necessarily like. So I'm gonna go over a little. And up a little. And she says to use, I think I might use dimensionals on this so that you can kind of see through it. I think that's what I will do. So I have some dimensionals in my set from what I was doing last night. So I'm going to put one here. And you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to be a little more frugal. And use pieces of them. And let's see, I'd kind of like a couple on the side. I think I can do that with this. Nope, I'm going to cut this in half. And then I'm going to peel off the top so that I can line up this bottom part with the very bottom of his of this picture. Oops, and I don't want to stick that on there yet. I'm trying not to stick it on. I'm just trying to line it up so I have it where I want it. Which is just about like that, I guess. So now I will stick that on there. And then I will go to the other side and peel off these guys. They will also adhere. Okay, and then I need to trim the edge of this. So that you can't see. And then, so this is how it's going to look on the card. And I'm going to use some snail on the back of this to adhere it to the card. And I think I just put it in the middle, yeah. And then I'll just make sure that that's stuck down. Oh, isn't that cute? I'm liking that a lot. And I think I can put a sentiment on the inside, maybe. Let's see, what are the sentiments? I don't even know. I don't even know what I do with my sheet. I guess I'll have to read it backwards. Which Way to the Candy, Haunt You Later, Have a Fangtastic Halloween. I will put that one on. So again, I'm just taking this off the rubber, and then I'm peeling the backing off. And I'm going to put my Dracula on my paper, and I will clean these in the bathroom when I'm done. I'm just going to clean them in the sink with not paper towel, and not a Kleenex, because the Kleenex would get everywhere, but like a little hand towel. And I can do it with some soap and water if I need to, or just water, depending. I'll try to do just water, but if it doesn't come off with that, I'll use a little soap too. So, this is good. I need to send out some Halloween cards. The problem with the rubber stamps that I don't like is that if you get them crooked, you can't see on the thing where they are. So if you put it crooked on the stamp and then you stamp straight, the thing's going to be crooked, which is not unlike me. So actually I did a pretty good job. Have a Fangtastic Halloween, and it's pretty straight and it's really cute. I was going to show you the front. It's really cute, isn't it? Well, I haven't put the thing on yet, have I? I need to adhere this to this, and then it will be really cute. That's my best Dracula imitation. Not good, I know. I can't do any voices or like accents at all. It's horrible. I am such a Midwestern girl. So we will put this down kind of in the middle. And Misty, you did it again, girl, because this is a cute, 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 cute card. I really like it as it's falling. That was funny. Let's try that again. Whee! Okay, small things make me happy. Okay, so that's really cute. So card number one is done, done, done. And we are rocking and rolling in the hotel room. I'm going to put, well, I won't put it in the sack yet so I can take a picture when I'm done. So moving along to number two. Usually there's three cards in a project. I don't know if I'll do the project. It depends on what it is. Yeah, it's a cute little box, so I'm not going to do the project because I do not want to have to pack that in my suitcase. So this is a Haunt You Later stamp, and we are going to do a cute little kitty cat. And it looks like this is this one. And I'll put the paper over there. And this is adorable. So again, she has all of this is already cut. I really would recommend these to somebody who, if you haven't stamped before, or if you haven't gotten into cards and you're just trying them, I would highly recommend these kits because things are already cut for you and the instructions are very easy to follow, only I don't. So do what I say, not what I do. And also, I think it's really cool that, oh no, the moon doesn't look like it's cut out, so I will have to cut that out. But anyway, it's just very, very nice. I think that you would really like this. And if you've been a long time stamper or a scrapbooker or card maker or whatever, you'd still find these cards interesting. I mean, I do. I've stamped and crafted for a long time. So this is kind of a Starry Night scene. So I'm using that side. If you wanted to make a different card, you could use this side. That's one thing that's really cool about the Stampin' Up! Designer paper, is that it's all two-sided and both sides are usually something that you would like. And there's going to be like a cat walking on this little plank. I don't know if it's a plank. It just looks wooden. So I'm going ahead and getting all of this together. And this, let's see. Yeah, using the 2-inch circle punch. I'm supposed to punch a moon. All right. I'm using the basic black ink, stamp and cut, the cat and two pumpkins. All right, well, I can do at least the stamping part, so let's go with that. And I can try to cut a circle, I suppose. Where's my stamps? Here they are. So I have a kitty cat, which I love myself some kitty cats. Makes me miss my Mr. Fuzz and my Jambo. They would usually be up here with me, trying to see what Mama is doing. My poor baby kitties. And this doesn't have to be straight because I'm going to be cutting this image out, so it doesn't matter if it's straight or not on my paper. So let's just take a corner of this and stick on my pretty little kitty. Oh, that is cute. And then I will do two pumpkins. And we will cut these out. These are bigger pumpkins than I expected them to be. He's a big pumpkin. I don't know if I'll have anything orange to color these, so I may not be able to color these yet, but that is all right. I will do what I can, and what I can't, I will do at home. It would be kind of fun to send some of these from Dallas, because then the postmark would be Dallas, and people would be like, what the heck? If they paid any attention to that, but honestly, they probably wouldn't. I don't know if I would. Okay, so there's those. I have my cat and my two pumpkins already on here, and I know that I can do my cat with some of this black. I'm sorry, my hand is totally covering this up, so I don't know what you can see. So Stampin' Up! Does in colors every, I think the way that they work is every 2 years they get new in colors, but then retire an old one. Something like that. Or maybe it's every year. Okay, I think that's it now that I think about it. I could be wrong, so look this up if you're really interested. But I think it's every year they get new in colors, but every 2 years they retire them. So right now, there's always two sets of in colors. The one that will be retiring and then the one that's new. And these paper pumpkin that the kits that you get from Stampin' Up! That is also a monthly subscription, and you also don't know what you're getting. And I think it's $25 or $20 a month. And if you know a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator, they can get you a discount on the first couple of months. At least that's the sale that was going on when I did it. I think I even got my first month free or something, but you can, or $10 or something, but you can do, I think there's discount going on right now. Whatever the discount is, if you know a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator, they can help you get that discount, and it's kind of fun because I enjoy getting fun mail, and it's kind of nice because most of the time the cards that they give you or the project that they give you, like this month it's these cute, I don't even know what they're called, but like treat bags that look like brooms. They're very cute. Now they are small, I will say they're small. I have done these before with lunch bags from like just regular lunch bags, and they're a lot bigger, but these are very, very cute, and I can see how, I mean, that's just a neat treat. I'm going to do them, I think, and it looks like you get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm going to do them and give them to some of the people in my office, so I thought that would be cute. So I just colored the cat. I'm going to make his eyes green. I'm going to color just a little bit off just to make sure that it does it, and it does. And then I'm going to color his eyes green. And I'm going to get a little bit of this purpley color here, even though this ink is not the best for doing this, but I'm just going to do his ears, the inside of his ears. and his nose, even though his nose could probably be black, I'm just making him a little cuter because I love cute cats. And I think I will do a little bit of green and then go over it with the early espresso on this stem and kind of blend those colors together maybe. We'll see what we can do. So there's the green, and then I will, oops, that's Cajun. I don't want that one. I want this early espresso. And, ooh, that came out really dark. Didn't mean for it to be that dark. I meant for it to be more like that. So there's those pumpkin stems, and there's my kitty cat. The pumpkin stems almost look black, so I'm probably going to try to do something with that. I don't know what exactly. Let's try to add some taupe or something. I don't know. This probably isn't going to work. But bit the blender pen. I'm hoping. And no, it didn't do anything. Let's try this Tip Top taupe. It'll probably make it more... Oh, and then I'll go over it with some green again. So we'll try that and see if that does anything. No, not really. I'm just kind of making it ugly. Oh, well. Okay, so let's see. What could I color this pumpkin in? Maybe some of the Cajun craze. Let's see how that looks on it. The Cajun craze, man. If you color too much, it like lifts up the paper, but I kind of like it sometimes doing that. It kind of makes it look a little, I don't know the word, maybe vintage or something. I'm just kind of tearing up that paper. I did a little too much on that one. So let's see here. So it's kind of funny, this week is crazy for business trips. My boss and some of my peers are in Orlando right now at a convention, and I am in Dallas for a user group meeting, which is like all the people that, not all the people, well, all the people that use this vendor, they are invited to the user group meeting. And I think it's just for North America, but I could be wrong. And it could be, you know what, now that I say that, I bet it's for, no, I don't know. I don't know if it's international or not, but it's pretty neat and it's kind of cool. There's usually not a ton of people here because it is kind of pricey, but it's very good for networking and very good for asking questions about, you know, like, hey, our system does this and we don't really understand why it's doing this. Does yours do this and what do you do about it? And things like that. It's really kind of neat. So actually this Cajun did pretty well on these. So I'm going to go for it. And I'm just going to cut these out. And the convention actually starts tonight, or the user group meeting actually starts tonight. And we have to just register and get signed up. And then tomorrow morning, there's a big meeting. And tomorrow, I think it starts at 8 o'clock. And then it goes until 7 o'clock tomorrow night. And then there's a dinner after that. And so I'll be at the convention almost all day tomorrow. And then Wednesday, it starts bright and early again and goes until 4. And then there's a dinner again. And then... there's just some things later in the week as well. So, Joe actually, who is with me, he has to leave on Wednesday. They're doing something at his school or at his kid's school or something like that on the weekend. And he needed to be home before then. So he actually is leaving a little bit earlier than they suggest, and I am staying until Saturday, which will be fun, I suppose. I am so excited because I know I've mentioned it before, but Misty, the Jolly Fat Elf, and Christy Robbins, who is, if you look, if you just Google Christy Robbins, I think her blog is called Gumdrops and Glitter, Glitter and Gumdrops. She is amazing, crafty. She does not do YouTube, but she does do a blog, and she is awesome. She does, I think she still posts daily. I mean, she's just an incredible blogger. And she also does the Good Morning Texas show here in Dallas as the craft person. And it's awesome. I'm so proud of her. So I am excited to meet both of them. I believe I'm going to meet Christy tonight. I'm not sure when I'm going to meet Misty. Hopefully, well, you know, it'll be soon because it's I'm only here for the week, so. And I think we're going to do a collaboration video of some sort, which will be fun. And if you guys do not know of them, I will try to remember to post their information below so that you can get it. And if I fail to do so, if you guys would kindly remind me, I will be happy to put it in the comments if I don't put it in the thing. Sometimes when I'm downloading these, especially if I download this from the hotel, I can see me totally forgetting, and I don't like to do that. I try to remember everything, but sometimes I forget. We're only human, aren't we? So I'm just cutting out this sweet kitty cat who I'm sure is not supposed to be sweet, but I can't help it. All kitty cats are sweet to me. I'm cutting off his whiskers just so I can cut him close. Doot, 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 doot. So crafting from the hotel room, card making in the hotel room, that's pretty fun. Now there is a, I don't know if I'm going to say it right, a Daisio store here in Dallas or close to Dallas. I think I might try to do that later in the week when Joe's not with me just because he's not interested in that. And then Christy sent me a couple other shops that I might like to look at, so I think I'll spend like Thursday or Friday searching out those things. and then what am I trying to say? We'll do things that Joe kind of wants to do during the, like today. We were going to think about, well, we were thinking about going to the aquarium and such. And they have some really cool things to do here in Dallas, but I don't know. Both of us are a little bit boring, and both of us kind of, I don't know. We said that we liked to do things like that, and it's fun, but I'd almost rather, and this is no offense to Joe, and I know he wouldn't take offense. I'd almost rather do this, do that kind of stuff with my family. So, you know, I think that that's, we're just going to not do that kind of stuff. Look at me. I had some washi tape. Cut out a moon. Way to go. That was nice thinking. I was going to try to hand cut a circle, but I like that this idea better because I don't know that I could do a circle very well. I don't know I'm doing a great job this way either, but that's okay. It's better for sure than what I would have done without it. So there we go. Okay. Now it looks like we put this up here in the sky. And I don't know. Does she have? I mean, I can do it however I want. I I'm going to cover up some of that pumpkin that I don't like because I screwed him up. I'm going to put this one down, just regular snail. And then I'm going to lift the second one up with some dimensionals. If I can find them, here they are. And I'm going to cut these dimensionals just because I'm so frugal. It's ridiculous, I know. I can't help it. Especially when you're crafting from the hotel room. You need to make sure that you have enough to last you. Right? Right. And I'm going to cut just a little piece of one for this stem so it won't accidentally fall off. At least I think I am. Oh goodness. It doesn't feel like it's sticky. That's weird. There, that one feels sticky. Okay, and then I'm going to peel off these little backs of these. So I have on jamberry nails, and I've had them on for a week. I think a week today. And they're still decent, but they're not great. I think I, like some of my nails are bad. Others of them look all right. I think I just am hard on my nails. I think crafters in general are probably hard on our nails. So it's about time that I do them again, but, and I did bring some samples. I could probably do, like I could probably take, oh, I didn't bring, no, never mind. I didn't bring any nail polish remover. So then I'm going to put him kind of walking on this. I don't know if I want to dimension him up or if I want to stick him down there. Or dimension him up. I think I'll dimension him up. Except for I think I will take his tail and stick him down. Like the tail will be sticking down on the paper. But his body will be dimensioned up. I think that might be cool. And I'm doing that because I also don't want his tail to fall off. It's so thin and I'm traveling and all that stuff. So, and I will put him walking on this board. That's cute. So you see that his tail's kind of stuck down a little bit and then his body is raised a little. And one of those pumpkins is down and the second one is raised. And that's really cute. I like how that turned out. And then I'm going to put a sentiment on this as well. And I think on this one I will say haunt you later, which is what I think she suggested too. Yes, this is the haunt you later stamp or card. So I will put this on here. And I need to try to stick it straight. One secret kind of to make them straight is if you lay it on the card straight, and then you go down on this straight. It might help, but I don't know. I don't always have the best luck with it. And one thing I should have maybe done, which I would suggest for you guys, is to not stamp this or not put this down until you've stamped this, because if you get it crooked, you could use the other side. But I'm living dangerously, apparently. It's a little crooked, but not too bad. Haunt you later. Cute. That's a really cute card. Way to go, Misty. Two for two, baby. Two for two. And this is stamping in the hotel room. I am so impressed with myself. Oh, yes, I is. Now this next one is really cute. It's a witchy witch card. Oh, and it's so cute. Now, look at the fun stuff you get in here. Let me tell you, that is cute. And this paper is like jack-o'-lantern-y. Oh, and on the other side it has a ravens. So cute. Look at the spider web. Oh my goodness, I am loving it. Now, I would probably take like glue, like a glue pin, and stick this down if I were at home. That's how I would stick something that fine down, but I don't have that because I'm not at home. So we will just go with what we have because that's what we're doing. So I'll put the little wrapper over there, and then I will go ahead and put the sentiment on here, which is, which way to the candy? Oh yeah, girl after my own heart. Let me see how this looks. So it looks like we're doing some cutouts again. And the little girl has a frog. Oh yeah, she does have a frog. So this one's kind of bent, so I'm gonna use that one for the cutouts. And this one I'm going to put down, try to center it up again like I said before. Let's see if I do okay with that. I don't even know what time it is and that thing just went off. Doo-doo-doo. Like maybe I have a message or something. I know it's still early enough. I am getting a little hungry, so it's probably about 10, I would guess. And I did buy some pumpkin-y fiber one bars. So maybe I will have one of those before we go and eat. Which way to the candy? And see, since I stamped it this way, it is allowing me to use the other side if I needed to. But because I did it this way, of course I don't need to because I did it straight. This is like the only one I did absolutely straight, of course. So now I will stamp the earth, whatever this is called, snail this, and put it on the inside of this pretty purple. This is a pretty purple. Pretty, pretty, pretty. Okay, and looks like we will stamp and color the witch, and then it also looks like we have some of this going around this, and I want to make sure that I have this on the side where you can see the jack-o'-lantern smiles kind of up. And so I'm just going to wrap this around a few times. Let's get to the end, shall we? Let's do that. Let's do it this way. And wrap, wrap, wrap. And then I will tie it here. And you can tie this in a knot or tie it in a bow. Throw it over your shoulder like a continental soldier. I crack myself up sometimes. I know that's pitiful. I can't help it. So. And also in the kit that you get, you not only get the full stamp set and all of these things to make four projects that are already cut out, you also get like extra stuff. Like this time was the blending pin. That's the only reason I even brought it, was because it came with this kit. So she kind of shows a new technique, and or maybe new to some people or maybe not, I don't know, like how to use the blender pin. I'm just trying to get this bow tied kind of straight because bows are sometimes difficult, and I think that that did it. So I'm going to cut off this excess string here, and I'm going to move this bow a little bit more to the side. So to do that, I'm just kind of pushing it on both ways so it goes to the side a little bit more, and then I can put him here. But first I'm going to put this down, which is what she has. And let's see, so I'm going to do it this way, I think. And I'm going to take, what am I going to do? to get this down. I would normally just glue this. I guess I'm going to have to use my snail, so I'm just going to have to be real careful here. I would not recommend this. But because I don't have anything else, that is what I'm going to do. And so this one is not covered in snail, just so I know. And I'm going to have to put some okay, now carefully lift them up. And one of these doesn't have snail on it, this one. Because I'm going to have to cut him off. Okay, so it did the trick. Some of this might be a little sticky, but I'm just going to have to be careful. I'm going to just poke that off because I can tell that I could. And then I'm going to cut those guys off. Oh, he's crooked. I want to get him straight. And there we go. So now I can put him down. I'm just going to be careful to put him over where I have some snail sticking through. And I'm going to put some snail on this on the twine, which is probably not what I would normally do, but oh, and this doesn't cover the whole thing, so I just need to be careful to not to center it. There we go. I thought that it would cover the whole thing, so no problem. It actually looks very cool. This is cool just like this, actually. I think that looks neat. I love that spider web doily. So what I was saying is she gives you a package of stuff, and there is spiderweb doilies in there, and then there's also paper. And I did a haul on what we got, so if you guys are interested in seeing what all you get, I mean, I did all of the papers that you got, and then the doilies, I showed those. So feel free to watch that video, and you will be delighted, I think. And I mean, if you guys wanted to join this stamp club, I would highly recommend it. Oh, and it looks like maybe this goes on the inside. I don't know. Or maybe she just gave me a little extra. I think I will put it on the inside, though. So let's just go ahead and do that. And I'm not going to go all the way to the bottom because I noticed that this is a little longer than this. So I'm just going to put this like this. And then I will cut this off at the bottom here. And there we go. And so now I need to take the extra sheet and I need to stamp this cool witch. And she's going to be cute. And then we get to color one last time, I think. Well, I know we get to color. I don't know if it's the last time or not. And I'm going to stamp, stamp, stamp. Ink, ink, ink. I keep saying stamp. Make sure she's all inked up. Oh, I just turned that ink upside down. Oh, well. I will clean this up. I don't want the housekeeper to have to clean up my mess. I will say that it is quite nice, though, being somewhere where I don't have housework to do. Just clean up after myself and I'm good. Oh, I won't do the black first. So, I want her to have a green face. She colored it with a skin-colored face, so we're kind of doing opposite what she did with the vampire and what I'm doing. Oh, I see why she probably did that, because this frog is right next to her face and the frog will be green too. Oh well. So yeah, I am getting hungry. Let me show you what I got. I have these Fiber One 90 calorie pumpkin bars. I didn't really buy them because they were 90 calories, but I just noticed I bought them because they were pumpkin bars. Looks like you get 6 bars. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes. There. They smell good. Let's just open it up and see what it looks like, because I'm a hungry girl. Oh, it's tiny. No wonder it's 90 calories. Good lord. This is a bar. No, this is a square. This is a little square of pumpkin hopeful goodness. But it is not a bar. Smells delightful. Mmm, it tastes yummy too. Not bad, not bad at all. I'm gonna try to make this frog a little greener. Oops, then I'm making her face, but we shall see. It is what it is, peeps. I might go over the frog a little bit with some brown. But that brown a little bit goes a long way, so I'm going to just do a dab, and then I'm going to go over here and wipe some of it off, and then I'll go into the frog. And I'll do the same thing again. That way they're different shades. That looks kind of cute. Oops. Where's my lid? What is this? Oh, the espresso. Okay. Now I will do the black. And do her hat. And I might use that purpley color again and do the belt of her hat. Well, it's kind of pinkish, purplish, mauve-ish. I don't know what color it is. Let me get some of this black off. I don't know what color I'm going to do her dress yet either. Let's see how this looks. It looks purple. That's cool. I might do her dress in that purple too. I don't know if that's called a dress, a witch's dress, her costume, her robe. I don't know. I'm not a witch, so I don't know what you call them. Cloak. Now I'm thinking about Harry Potter. I need to watch Harry Potter again. I haven't seen him for a while. I think in March I'm going to go to the Disney and see the Harry Potter exhibit or whatever it's called, the Harry Potter Land. And I think that's at Universal, but my daughter has a dance competition. And this is her last one as a senior, because she's a senior. So it would be cool to go and see it. So that's what my plan is right now anyway. I haven't purchased the ticket or anything. I probably need to get on that, but other expenses come first. Whoops, I just turned that over too. I'm just making a mess in the hotel room. I'm going to do this color for her hair. So by the time I post this, actually, it will probably be not this week while I'm here at the hotel. It will probably be after I've gotten back. I don't know. It depends on how quickly I can get it to download and such. My laptop keeps beeping. I think it's just emails that are coming in, but it's making me worry. Not really worry, but think, oh goodness, is that a reminder that I need to be somewhere? But I know I don't have to be anywhere until later tonight, so I'm okay. I just am paranoid because it feels weird to be doing this right now. Okay, I don't have yellow, so I'm going to have to use this kind of weird color to do the star and the buckle on her hat and even her eyes. I think I will do this color. So there she is, kind of cute. I might do his mouth in this color too, just so he has, it's not like white. I might do a little bit of espresso. I don't know, I kind of like it now that I'm looking at it for a second time. Yeah, I think I like it. So now I will just cut her out. And I ended up only using one side of this blender pen for all of that. So blender pens are pretty cool. I just don't think that one is wet enough. Excuse me while I take a bite. I love all the pumpkin stuff this time of year. The pumpkin spice latte at Starbucks. I haven't even seen a Starbucks here. They have a coffee shop in the hotel, which is decent. The coffee in the hotel room isn't the best, but the tea is good. They give you a couple choices. I've only had one kind. It's like a citron. It's citrus something. I think I might still have the tag on here. It's from T Forte. Oh, and it doesn't tell you the kind, but it's like a citrusy kind. And it's really good. And then, oh, I shouldn't put that right there, should I? And then they have a black tea, which I haven't tried yet. I don't know why. I'm kind of more into the flavored teas. And I'll tell you what, that one from Trader Joe's, the Harvest Blend, is phenomenal. And I still need to get some for a random act of kindness that I need to do. I want to send her some Trader Joe's pumpkin-y stuff. I need to try to send her some. I'm going to try to get that, and I'm going to try to get something else pumpkin-y, and then I'm also going to try to get the pumpkin chai. They didn't have that the last time. Oh, the pumpkin JoJo's. I was going to get those for her. So, I need to get on that when I get home. I should probably write that in my planner. That way I won't forget. So I'm just carefully cutting her out. She is cute with this little frog. This is a really cute set. And next month's set, she always does a video to show us what we're getting. Next month's set is a Christmas set that I absolutely love. And she also offers some discounts on some supplies. If you are interested in purchasing those, you just tell her and she will send you the invoice. I know we pay by the 5th of every month. And like if you're a subscriber, she has you pay a certain amount every month for like 4 months, and then you don't have to pay the rest of the year. So that's pretty cool for me, because then I don't have to even think about it anymore. I just know that I get a sweet package coming every month and I'm done. So I think that this is the fifth month, so I think that I know I don't have to pay this month, so this is the first time I don't have to pay, but I will be getting all of my goodies. But if you want to add on, she'll send you just an invoice for whatever it is that you added on, and she sends it all free shipping to you with your order, so that's kind of nice too. And right now is the holiday catalog, so we can order from that. And if you already have the stamp set that she's giving, then you have the opportunity to purchase something else instead. And I'm going to use dimensionals to dimension her up because of that ribbon or twine. So I think that it's a really good deal. I know that it's a little bit pricey sometimes, but you get your money's worth, because she makes sure that you get more supplies than you've paid for, if that makes any sense. Like, if let's say you spend $55 on the kit, she will make sure that you get like $65 or more of stuff in your goodie bag. The only thing is, you don't know what you're getting, so if that bothers you, that probably wouldn't be something that you'd be interested in. But if it doesn't bother you and you like surprises, it's fun. Let me just tell you, I would highly recommend it. And I'm a little crazy with the dimensionals, and I probably shouldn't have, because I don't know where this is going to go on this. So, oh well, I'll just do my best to make the dimensionals not in the way of the twine. Maybe I'll move this one up just a hair, and then move this one down a hair. And then I'll try to put the twine in the middle. Look at me go. Look at me go. That's one thing about these dimensionals too. You do have the opportunity to move them just a little bit if you need to. And I don't know if it's forever. I would imagine it's just for a little bit until they get really stuck on there. So here is where I have my hole for the twine to go through. Oh my goodness, this one might be my favorite card. Look how cute that is. So there is the first card, or the third card, however we're doing this. This is the second card. And this is the other card. They're all very, very cute. And I have enough here to make more cards if I choose. And then I also have my cool project that's already cut out and ready for me to go, but I'm not going to do it right now because I don't want to take home a 3D project, which would, you know, be silly. It would just get crushed in my luggage. So there we go. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day. Happy Halloween!